because we're going to say some really good stuff tonight. Good evening, everyone. And this is Sharon Rankin and Nancy Jakovac zooming in from Amelia Island, Florida. And we are post-conference. We are post-Juice Plus Live, where we had a phenomenal time. And we'll get to that in just a minute. This is our weekly team call. Every week we come together as the Mission Possible team. And it really is about inspiring healthy living around the world as a team, as individuals, starting with our family, our friends, our neighborhoods, and then expanding from there. And we are post-conference, and we have so much to share, so I'm going to give a little bit of a disclaimer. Yes, we're on Eastern time, so if we go past the top of the hour, you guys are going to have to forgive us. There's just so much to share that we're actually going to break it down into 2 weeks. It was one of the most incredible conferences that we've had in quite a long time. It's been 3 years. The last time the Juice Plus family came together was in October of 2019, and as you know, we have been walking through some very challenging times, but the company found a way for us to gather again, and there were well over 3,000 people who joined us. And I just want to give you a heads up that the next conference in the spring, I think April the 20th through the 22nd, 2023, will be in Phoenix, Arizona, and they're planning for a phenomenal time. And we love to go to Phoenix in April. It is warm, it's beautiful, and coming out of winter, we all need it. So put it on your calendar now. We want to give you a strong invite to make a plan. Put it in your big rocks to be there, because this is some of the best times we'll ever see with the Juice Plus family. So the theme of the conference was the power of now, the power of you, take action, and I'm going to add then the power of possibility. So tonight, we just want to talk about the power of now, mostly a little bit about the power of you. And hopefully we have this organized in a way that will flow beautifully. So Sally's going to cue us up some videos, but I want to kick off with the Thursday night party. Thursday night, normally we come together for a healthy living talk. We're tired, we're flown in, but this time it was a total different vibe going on with a party, one of the biggest parties we've seen ever. I don't know how many people were there. There was music, there was food, it was free. And we had a superstar in our midst, our own Sherry Ferguson. So Sherry, unmute yourself, and you got to share a little bit about the fun that you had at the party, because you were on the big screen.
I don't know how I ended up, but anyway, I'm going to preface this by saying that when I first got into the business and went to my first conference and went to the party, of course, I didn't know anybody but my sponsor, really. But like Sharon was saying about the vibes, it just didn't have any vibes. So I haven't been to a party since. It's usually on Saturday night, and I usually cut out and go home. But since this time, it was Thursday, and I told Viola, I said, well, hey, let's go. Let's check it out and, you know, see what's going on. Well, see, the difference is before I didn't know Paula, and there was no Darlene and no Loretta Brown. And I'm telling you, you're talking about some party animals. So we were all just kind of dancing around, kind of at our own little place. And I said, okay. You know, I thought, well, that's enough of that. So I'm going to go over there. And Darlene, man, she's getting down. So I'm going to see if she'll get out there on the floor with me. So I went over to Darlene and Loretta, and somehow we all ended up out there. And I don't know how this happened, y'all. I'm telling you, the devil made me do it. But I mean, you know, we were out there dancing and all this stuff. And there was this nice looking young man, and he kept, you know, waving at me and kind of trying to get my attention and everything. And, you know, he was motioning for me to, you know, come on out there. And he had this dude with the camera up there. I thought, no, I'm not doing that. And he said, yeah, come. Next thing I know, everybody's splitting like the Red Sea. I mean, there's just, you know, there's people lined up like on both sides, and there's nobody out there but me. You know, what do you do now? And they just, I thought, hey, roll with it, baby. So, you know, I just, you know, did my thing. And as soon as I could, you know, got out of the way and got out of the view of the camera. But we had a great time. It was really good. The food was good. And I like, they had a set up, kind of for family. There were a lot of kids there, a lot of families, and they had cornhole, things for people to do. And it was just really great. I mean, everybody just, it just felt unified, we were all one big happy family and everybody just having a good, it really was like a reunion atmosphere. It really was. It's cool.
Thanks, Sherry. I love it. We saw you on the big screen. I go, Sherry, go. I think I saw Darlene on the big screen too. So we want to invite everybody. That's going to happen again in Phoenix. They're going to do another party, opening party and welcoming party on that Thursday night. So make plans to be there. So thank you. So I'm going to roll over to Denver and Sally's going to kick us off with a video that one of the pieces of power of now is, yes, we've had a look back at it, our historical piece, but then the rebranding of our products. So Sally, if you can cue up that video, we're going to roll it. I'll redo it. Stream. Can you see it?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Perfect. Thank you, Sally. And I'm going to zip into Paula, who's going to talk to us about the rebranding, which is the power of now. Have any of you seen your new bottles? Have you got new fruits and vegetable bottles? The berries and the omegas are coming. Okay, Paula.
Yeah, I got mine today for the first time. They are so beautiful. I love them so much. Okay, Sherry, I've never been called a party animal before, but I'll take it. That's awesome. We had so much fun. So tonight's going to feel like a fire hose of information, and that's good. It just shows that there's just lots happening, and you're just a part of something that's really exciting. So Friday morning kicked off with Stuart Kranagi, who is our new CEO. Stuart is a female, if you're not familiar, and she's been with the company just a couple of years and has just done a remarkable job already, and not only learning everything, but in the changes that she's made and implemented and things she has planned for the future as well. So it was really great to hear from her. So I'll just cover some of the highlights of what she shared. One just real technical thing. It's big to the IT kind of geeky people and maybe not so to the rest of us, but data has been managed right inside the home office in a room that all the servers are there, which has limitations. Everything's been moved to the cloud. That is a huge undertaking, but it really does allow for better speed and better accuracy of data. And obviously we know with the two back offices, that is still a work in progress, and we're hoping, that will continue to merge. And we're just encouraging everyone to use the new office to the extent possible to allow that transition to continue. There's been a 40% increase in the number of customers who are using the customer portal to manage their orders. So it's just showing that we're allowing customers more independence and being able to manage what they're doing. And then the partners, that frees us up to go out and do what we do best in talking to people. So that's wonderful. There have been 30,000 partners who have entered into the Juice Plus Hub for training. And even though we know that that's new too, and I think continued improvements will be made there, it is great to have just one place to go for everything. So if you haven't been to the hub, we do encourage that. For future sustainability, they have a goal of reducing the cardboard and plastic. So they're thinking about that footprint which is so important. And there was even a brief mention of a mobile app specific for partners coming up in the future. So that's kind of fun to think about as well. So I really think Stuart's just doing a great job of taking us to the next level and doing a just a wonderful job of carrying out Jay Martin's vision and mission. So I really appreciated the time with her. And then lastly, the she didn't share this, but I think Lisa Pepple shared this, that Acerola cherry is now going to be the sole source of vitamin C in the Trio capsules. So that's just good to know that we're using a whole food source completely for the vitamin C in our Trio whole food powders now. So that's what I have.
Perfect, Paula. That's a lot of information, and just stay tuned for more details. All right, Ann Isom, I'm going to jump over to you. That's going to talk about the newest product introduction that we have, and many of us got some samples when we were at conference.
Okay, well, I'm excited to share this because I know you all have experienced this as well as I have, that people won't drink our Complete because it's soy-based. I actually will have to say I was one of those people until I talked to Dr. Jan, and I felt totally comfortable with the soy in our product, but everybody doesn't understand the quality, the high quality of the soy that's in the Complete, and you tell them it's soy-based and they won't drink it. So no more worries. Coming out very soon, we are going to have soy-free, plant-based whole food Complete shakes. So that's going to be a real asset to everyone. And then also they are working on adding new flavors to our Complete. And I know that's been a source of communication and talk with people when we've shared Complete. So the company is listening and they know the need and they're making things happen. And also something else that we've all wanted, I know with the new performance, to be able to share a sample with people, they're going to be coming out with the sample packs, the individual packs of Perform. So they're doing what they need to do, and we're all going to benefit from it. So thank you.
Thanks, Ann. And I'm going to move over to Beth, and maybe Dr. Wanda might chime in as well. But Beth is going to talk about the Juice Plus Science Institute. And this is a huge deal, and they spent 3 or 4 years working on this, and it's now ready to go. So, Beth.
Very exciting. All you have to do is go to jpsi.info. Juice Plus Science in scienceinstitute.info, and you can sign in. We did that, a couple of us that were traveling together did that together, and we signed in, and right away you'll see the Juice Plus research right above that, right away when you first get in, and then who's on in the Science Institute. But the neat thing about this is a worldwide, this is for worldwide research, all about the benefits of plant-based nutrition. We're the leader in this. We are the leader in this. And now we have this institute. There's going to be people, researchers from all over the world doing research that will be published, and it's going to be just exciting. And just real quickly, just so you new people don't know this, we literally have 39 studies, published clinical studies on Juice Plus. Well, 33 are clinical trials. That's unheard of, showing what Juice Plus does to our body. Published in 47 peer-reviewed scientific journals. That means it takes a lot to get in that kind of journal, and Juice Plus is there. And the new studies right now show improved cardiovascular health, improved microbiome health. You know, Juice Plus does amazing things for us. And I just think, I love the presentation at the conference about this, because it wasn't just our wonderful director, Dr. Manfred Leprecht, but also Dr. Reginald Fowler, who we see on Bridging the Gap. He came out with just as a wonderful, elegant man, and really explained things in a way that we could understand these new studies. So he was really delightful. So we're very excited about this. And they say the sky's the limit with the research. Uh-oh. Sharon, are you there? Okay.
Well, looks like they froze. They froze. Yeah. why don't we go on to, let's see, shall we do Sandy? Do you want to do the family health study? And then we'll go to Cheryl with Performance Center.
That's good.
Go for it.
Okay. Okay. You want me to share the slides?
Yes. I'm sorry. We've been frozen.
Okay. So on our family health study, children's health study, which I still call it, There are just a couple of added support things to it, which is really awesome. One of them is this flip book. So it's not a video. For a second there, I was thinking it was another video, but it's not. It's a flip book in Canva, and Sally is going to show it. So we can actually access this on our phones and go through it with people or send it to people. So do you have that queued, Sal?
I'm going to have to find it again. It just disappeared.
So I'll talk about the booklet then. I flipped my Zoom image so that you could see it. You can actually read it, right? Give your family a healthy nutritional start. There's this little booklet also on the family health study brochure. It's different than the flip thing. This has more information in it, and it talks about all the products, and it has some research. So it really is kind of an all-inclusive booklet. It even lists some of the doctors that we work with and where they're located, which I think is phenomenal. So if we have customers in those areas interested in contacting these people, that's really cool. And then it talks about the healthy starts and what it's about and the parameters of it. And then the research results are also on here for the health study. And then it has Tower Garden. So this is a really comprehensive booklet. And it talks about the foundation too and our charitable connections. So a fabulous, fabulous book. I gave one out at the airport to the Sky Cab as we were going because I had them. And he wanted me to hook him up with the family health study. So I gave him one of those. It was really awesome. I had one.
All right. It appeared again. Here we go.
Okay.
So this is a link, and we'll make sure it's posted in all of our Voxer chats. And you can just send this.
I'm sure that'll be on boards soon.
Yeah, and it'll probably be on boards soon if it's not already.
Yeah, I haven't seen an update yet.
Yeah, it's just something that you can send to somebody that can flip through and get all these great images and inspired about what we are. Testimonials, and then families.
So lots of stories, lots of pictures, and lots of stories.
Yep, that's it.
Thank you, Sally, and thank you, Sandy. And another piece of information that we got was the United States Performance Center, and Cheryl Schapetto is going to come in and share about this. This is a big deal, guys, what's happening with Juice Plus and athletes, world-class athletes.
Thanks, Sharon. Sally, do you want to show the video before or after?
We're working Sally tonight.
I know.
Yeah, you're working me. All right, I'm happy to share it right now.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Let me get it. I don't know how to make it full screen, but here we go.
It's fine.
So very exciting. We announced at this conference that the United States Performance Center is partnering with the Juice Plus company to provide encapsulated fruit, vegetable, berry, functional food powders, and plant-based omegas to every Olympic and national team athlete. that trains with them. So the USPC, those are their initials, have a fueling station, and they also have the Juice Plus Complete protein powders and the Juice Plus Perform powders so that each athlete can have this to improve their performance, their recovery, and their glycogen replacement. So, and I learned today that they're also doing blood work on these athletes prior to taking all of these products, and then as they go taking these products. So, oh my gosh, how exciting is that? So what this means, at least this is how I'm perceiving it, you know, building belief for us as affiliates, feeling confident that we can be very bold in talking to someone about our products because they're using them in Olympic settings. So with the highest level of athlete. Also for our customers that are already using our products, what a great thing to forward to them about this news that we're partnering with them. And then lastly, with potential customers. So coaches, trainers, athletes, parents of athletes, you know, just having that confidence. And this is just such a great resource to share with them. So our complete, the perform, and then all four sets of capsules. I'm super excited about it. Thanks.
And that's so applicable to just the everyday athlete too, right? Is what you're saying, Cheryl.
Yes, we need to absolutely
let parents know that their kids need this. Everybody needs this like never before. So, and I think I don't know if Joyce Hammer's question got answered, but we will still have our regular chocolate and vanilla complete. That is not going away. For sure. So thank you, Cheryl. And I'm hoping I've covered everybody on the product, on the power of now. If not, somebody's going to have to jump in. Oh, we do want to talk about Tower Gardens really quick. And I don't know. I didn't see Janae on here. Is she here? She was going to talk about it. Okay, go ahead, Janae.
Okay. Well, starting today, we are launching in Europe for the Tower Garden. So we can ship to United Kingdom, Ireland, Germany, France, and Spain. And in about 4 to 6 weeks, we will also do Italy, Netherlands, Austria, and Switzerland. So that's really exciting. They actually have made the Tower Garden home a little bit smaller to fit, I believe, like in one box. So shipping will be better for those people. And also starting November 1st, we are going to be able to get the Tower Garden Home Support Cage is going to be available for us and for in Europe. So that's exciting. They were talking a lot about using resources on the hub. So if you want to learn about how to get Tower Gardens in schools, I would definitely write this down so you know where to go. So go to the hub. Resources, United States, Tower Garden, Tower Garden Schools. So, and I took an image of that so I can put that on Voxer so you guys have the step-by-step of where to go. Let's see. Oh, one of the women on stage talking about Tower Gardens, mm-hmm. They shared powerful stories. She said that God made us food, we need to grow it. And that was just very heartfelt for her journey. And then kind of closing out was Stephen Ritz. And he was sharing about lesson plans that we get, you know, with the Tower Garden information for in schools. Lesson plans are daily use, but curriculum gets the whole school involved. The curriculum has reading, writing, math, and science, and it's a sequence of lessons for the whole year.
Thanks, Janae. And one of the things that we heard was a panel of just average people who were impassioned about helping children who were really in food shortage issues get more food through Tower Gardens in the schools. So it was very, very inspiring. I want to flip over to Dr. Terrell. I don't know, as a medical professional, if she has something to say she wanted to say on the Science Institute or something that you heard. Dr. Terrell, I think I saw you here.
Yeah, actually, I missed most of the Science Institute lecture because we were traveling with a toddler and it made a little more difficult than usual. So I did miss a lot of that talk, and the part I heard was exceptional, but I do want to share, I was impacted quite a bit by the, and if I blank out, my battery on my computer is jacked up and I'm having to hold the plug in. So we'll see how this goes. By the NMD speeches, there are a lot of things that I found impactful for me personally. One was that there was more diversity among the new NMDs that I've ever seen, and that's in all aspects of diversity. There was age diversity from young people to up to that exciting, fabulous woman who was 80 years old, and she told us, ask us, please don't tell anybody her age. She was cute as a button. And then the path to NMD was different. There were rocket stars, but there were also some regular old people that had the slow path of people who had life interruptions. So I think the shortest was Viola, who impacted everybody, and she did it in 14 months. And but then there are people who, I think there was one who took 19 years, and that number stuck with me because I'm at 20 years and I'm not there yet. So you can see that everybody's path is different, and sometimes life interrupts your path and things, you just don't get it. But then the lady who became NMD, got the information, her promotion came while she was sedated. I don't know if she was on a ventilator, but that just blew me away. So it's possible for all of us. There was several people who had autoimmune diseases, and that really stuck out with me, that in their path and starting their Juice Plus, that they had, their autoimmune diseases were very positively impacted and they got better. And so that made me start thinking back about those studies that have been done on immune function and Juice Plus. There are three specific people that I wanted to share a little bit about that impacted me, and I'll end with the one that was the most powerful for me. So Tina Quinn said that she was stuck in the house, I think. She needed to understand decision-making and how to do that. And she made a decision to invest in herself, and she worked on herself. That she had a fear of what others would think of her for doing this business. And she ended with that she started each day with gratitude, and that she had a set time every day to work on her business, and we all need to do that. So she talked about having a clear vision, being persistent, and being grateful. And she ended with, if you can see it in your mind, you can hold it in your hand. Then there was Viola, who took everybody by storm. Just her story, her why was very clear. And I think that crystallized for me why it's so important to get that why that will keep you going forward. And two things that she said is that you can rewrite your story, that she was a chain breaker and a change maker. And then there was Dr. Paul, who his story was very impactful to me. He's a physician, OBGYN, and he said that he had thought that he would be delivering babies the rest of his life. That was what he saw for himself. But his wife developed a brain tumor. And on the day that they got that news, he was sitting in his car, I think going home. And he talked about the windows in the car getting steamed up. He didn't say exactly why, but I think we know what was going on with him in that car. But he said that at that moment, he realized the importance of making a life and not just making a living. And that really struck me personally, because I've been kind of struggling with where to go in terms of my medical practice and when I'm gonna make a change. But I mean, it just kind of crystallized for me that I need to recognize what's important and make those important things that are important to me happen. So that really struck. So that's about it.
Thanks, Dr. Terrell. Thank you so much. As you often see, there is a lot that we experience in just a couple of days. I'm going to close this off with Deanne Brodesen. That's going to talk. We talked about the power of now. We've heard about all some of the new stuff. The power of you really has to do with the NMDs. There were 28 new national marketing directors that walked across the stage, and many of them, some of them, as Dr. Terrell said, 20 years, 14 months, but there was a lot, 3, 4, 5 years. Guys, the last 3 years, we've been impacted by COVID and a pandemic, and it seemed to freeze everybody, but these people were not frozen. They kept on working in spite of it. So Deanne, I'm going to let you close this out, and anybody else that's going to share, we'll just share it next week because it's too much to get all in one call. So close this out, Deanne.
Well, really, Dr. Terrell really covered it very, very well. As far as things that happen in session, the NMD speeches are always my favorite. And what a bonanza it was, 28 speeches, and just trial and triumph and every walk of life and throwing all excuses away because these people had all kinds of excuses and figured out a way to do it. But one thing that impacted me, because it sounds so much like Sharon, it closes our call so many times saying, you know, go out and shine the light because people are praying for what we have. And one of the NMDs said, don't miss the opportunity to be the answer to someone's prayer. So same concept, but said just a little bit differently. That was one that I wrote down. We had a NMD who pre-recorded her speech and then danced to it. She is a professional dancer. You know, you don't have to get jiggy with it if you're not a dancer, but that was powerful and moving. We had one NMD that sang part of her speech. So lots of creativity, but I greatly admired Angela Conter. She is a mother of 10 children and homeschools them. And she said, I learned that I could be ridiculously focused and intentional for a season. And so for a season, she got up at 4 a.m. so she could work prior to her family getting up. So I don't know about you, but I think that throws away all the excuses we have. but I will end on that one because I thought that was so great. There's many, many more, but I love that our company was so kind to allow somebody who actually made NMD in 2020 or 2021 to have their time on the stage and their spotlight with a big crowd. So it was just really, really special.
We'll hear some more. Thanks, Deanne. We'll hear more about those as we go on in the power of you, because it is about the person for sure. So I'm going to close this off with Paula, who's going to let us know what to look forward this coming week that we can plug into.
So a common theme the entire conference was to wake up, get out of the COVID coma, and get back together. So hosting events, participating in events. So that's what we're going to talk about next week, is let's take action with what information we have. And so we can start that right away tomorrow. So this is just a reminder, we have the Healthy Living Affiliates call every Tuesday night, 7:30 p.m. Central. It's a great way for you to host something in your home and bring people over or invite people onto the Zoom. There's also encore calls that repeat that message. And this week, it's all about the affiliate income, so the business invitation. And these events just are a way to create a monthly rhythm of success. So we just encourage you to get on those calls, and we'll see you next week for more event education that we got from conference.
Perfect. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Phenomenal job. I can't even begin. There was just so much more to share, and we'll continue to share some of the nuggets and the pieces that we took away. So let's, we will post in the Voxer chat, and I'll also post it on our Facebook group, the Healthy Living Affiliate website, that you guys can click onto it for sure, and be sure to join in. If you haven't been watching these, you need to get the language down. We're fine-tuning this all the time. I'm having nothing to do with it except inviting people to the call. But anyways, everybody have a super, super week, and I'll just close with what Deanne said. Yes, people are out there praying for an answer for their health concerns and their financial issues. And we can be the answer to someone's prayers today. So let's go out and be a blessing to someone. Have a good week, everybody. Thank you.
Thanks, hey, thanks for your help, everybody.
Good night.
Bye, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you. Good night. Yeah. Thanks.
Great call.
Great call.